It's Arang, welcome back to my channel. Have you gotten your new planner for 2020? Today, I just wanted to share how I organize and decorate my planner to give you some inspiration. I want to start this video by asking you why you use your planner and what is the purpose of your planner. What are your priorities when it comes to using your planner? I feel like this is a very important question that a lot of people forget to ask themselves. Do you look to be more productive and on top of your time management game? Or are you seeking a mindful moment to track everything and contemplate about your future? This is something that you should think about. Because everyone's priority is different, the planner should be used differently. I just wanted to tell you to be conscious about why you're using your precious time to plan and draw things in your planners or bullet journal. I actually tried bullet journaling a few years ago and it didn't work out for me because I was so overwhelmed with all those drawings and creating all the layouts and stuff. It was just too much work for me. So I decided to go back to a normal planner and I implemented a few rules from bullet journaling. Don't get me wrong, bullet journaling is a very great system. What I really love about bullet journaling was the system constantly makes you omit stuff that you're not doing it or it's not worth your time. So it helps you to be selective when you're doing your task. I know it's not required, but I like to see something pleasing to my eyes. So I try to make it pretty as much as I can. And that took just forever and I wasn't happy with my planner. That discouraged me to use it. So what's the point? So what I realized was to just utilize whatever system is available to customize it. The important thing is whether the planner system is helping you to live with intention and purpose or be efficient and effective. So I'm gonna just walk you through what I do with my planner when I get my new planner, and we're gonna have some fun decorating with the least amount of time because the time is gold. This is my new planner for 2020, as you already have seen. I'll be using this cute deco kit. One of my subscribers sent it to me a few months ago. If you're watching this, thank you again. It has a variety of stickers, cards, paper clips, etc. Literally, this kit saved me a lot of time because it basically contained most of the things I needed. You know, searching for everything individually is time consuming. There are a couple of things that I do when I get a new planner. The first thing I do is customizing my planner to make it user friendly. Meaning, I divide the sections and make them easy to get to. I do this instead of having an index page, and it's been working just fine. I'm gonna skip the yearly section because I barely look at this page. There was an extra December 2019 monthly page, which would have been a nice feature if I started using this planner in December, but I don't need it, so I'm just gonna place a paper clip to combine the pages. Moving on to the weekly section, this planner has dates already, so I'm going to find the week that I'm starting and paperclip it. Here I have a bunch of stickers. Some of them were given to me by subscribers and some of them I bought in Korea. I have this very modern looking tab stickers. I'm just gonna put them on the monthly pages. When you're doing this, just be mindful about the alignment of the tabs and how they overlap. I mix up round and square shapes and then number them so that I can find the month easily. I usually go through the magazines chilling in my house and harvest the images that please my eyes and start decorating the planner with stickers and the pictures that I picked out. On the very first page, I placed this interior inspirational photo just because it matches with the color theme of the planner. These stickers are so cute, but you need to cut them out. I don't mind it because it's freaking adorable. Look at this. The kitties, they're just so cute. And also, a kitty sticker is a must because that way everyone knows it's mine. Actually, one of my friends told me that's how he knows something belongs to me, which is pretty accurate. I also put this sticker which reminds me of Batman. This is beyond cute. Look at his butt. And I'm just randomly picking out stuff to decorate the first page of the weekly section. Basically, there are no rules. If it looks pleasing to my eyes, that's good. I'm gonna try not to over-decorate the monthly section because my schedule will be pretty hectic, and this will be jam-packed with deadlines, exams, rotations, and appointments very soon. So yeah, I'm gonna keep it simple. On the first page of notes section, I have my 2020 resolutions because it depicts what I prioritize the most this year. This will be a great reminder of what I'm focusing on this year. So yeah, that's that. On the next page, I made a space to list all the books that I want to read this year and space for quotes that I want to keep in mind. And the next page is my monthly budget page. I wanted to keep it simple, so I just want to keep track on income and expenses for now. Basically, I'm using these note spaces for collections in a bullet journal. I'll be making more study notes here like I did in my 2019 planner. I usually write down things that I feel like I should know by heart or something clinical notes about my patients. And on the grid, I created habit trackers this year, and I thought this may give me motivation to keep it up, and we'll see what happens. And I thought it would be also satisfying at the end of the year to look back and see how I did. And this is how it looks like today. Imagine that the blank spaces are filled with colors. That will be so satisfying. Lastly, I like to write down my information just in case I lose my planner. This way, wherever my planner gets, it can come back to me. And I added a cute kitty sticker for extra luck. You never know, whoever finds it might be a cat owner and we watch each other's back, you know?
As you can see, I didn't draw anything. I just wanted to be minimalistic and I like it this way.
All right, this is it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope this video gave you a different perspective about using a planner or bullet journaling. And I love to hear what you do because you're my inspiration too. So I'll look forward to that, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!